Thank you. Your Highness not be glad, and so unimportant when one's a person of rank. Have I not morning after morning visited all the princess, Rioche, just to pay her my respects while in her she sat at ease with nothing except a tiny silk screen between her and me. I'm astounded that any lackey should dare.
Forgive the priest, my orders forgiven. They have obeyed them.
From the convent. She's an only child. Her father possesses 12 houses in the city and has a palace too. He's not over health. So I've heard it said.
Oh, cousin, I can see now which way the wind is blowing.
And if your highness will allow me, it seems to me I am not such a highly born and noble family. Say my blood is blue enough for war. I see with the social standing that my wife should have. She answers not the question, and as regards the children, if the queen should refuse them the gold and keys of nobility, the baron is still possessed the turbine keys to the 12 houses in the city for their consolation.
I'm sure your child and your
father
would do such consolation.
Well, I'm going with the chocolate. Come back here now. Wait. What is it?
What now?
If you will allow me, your highness. I haven't had a bite today.
And I'll bring it back and wait upon his lordship.
I'm nearly starving, my dear cousin. Sitting in my carriage, tied on a piece of flesh. From the way, I suddenly want to tell you, all my servants are here, horsemen and grooms and footmen. They are all gathered in the courtyard with my almanac. Give me another biscuit. Stay a while, you are the sweetest angel child. A crumb of bread, we're on our way to the white hunting where I shall be staying till tomorrow morning. If we tomorrow morning just you and I all alone together, then we're invited to stay with Faninal. Beforehand, I have to choose a fitting ambassador. Will you wait a minute? To my well and all and lovely bride, I will send him with a silver rose in his hand, and the old custom is among
all. Oh, the Valzacchi folk, as you both enjoy, small and you act as his ambassador.
Only because I need your highness' counsel on this question that I've been so bold to come so early and to appear all travel stained, to beg you humbly the favor that I ask for in my letter. I hope I don't press you too much, that with my request I have a little offense to your
house. A post, we must find someone to be a post.
Anything you want.
One of our kinsfolk.
You are the one for me.
Well, or cousin Lowell,
absolute discretion.
Well, will you not come and suffer then, dear cousin? Let's say tomorrow, with you,
of such grace and kindness, I thank you, your highness.
And now?
You must say, Faninal, stay here till you do.
Oh, stay where you are.
I hesitate to ask, but I'd be grateful to have an introduction to your again, if I may. I need advice on my marriage deed.
My attorney is coming this morning. Oh, see, my husband, perhaps he's in the anteroom and waiting.
I send the girl away. She really ought to be here and at your service. I'm not allowing. Take the mist all away, and you lie there, endless. I trust your highness.
Thank you. latest scandal news, keep your highness. All the latest news, scandal. Only give to pay to speak to the secret gossip to the dead and the empty room of one of the ministers of state and a doctor's wife having a love to poison the husband last night. And bring your props.
Take the first of the kids and go.
He lay took the contract through the violence in the great big world.
I will not listen. Take your tales to the kids and go.
Joy and
so.
in this special case.
The law, sir, and its wise prescriptions must in this most special case.
Then it is time it began for. If one who springs from the very noblest actions of our condescend as to any marriage one almost of the middle classes, like this Faninal, you understand me, take her to his bed, in fact, before God and the world, and as you might say, under the eyes of the
are you, sir?
The Baroni speak out of his eyes like Italian man.
Very man.
From this time, what he told
me. He's
a remarkable man.
Baroni, your popular opinion, sir.
You?
Yes.
Oh, for the peace and together we do better.
Better.
The Baroni's very, very young.
And just how do you know you're after me?
The Baroni is a gentleman. Keep up with me. Now tomorrow is ready.
Now
tomorrow is ready. Every step in the history. Every charity lady you take. Every letter in the lady you get. We are heirs.
What a place it is! It's all Vienna, I guess you know. Do you know that girl, Marianne? The serving girl who waits on her highness.
They go to the wall, it's in song.
May I now introduce the counterpart of your Marianne to your highness, and all that thou likest is unmistakable. Therefore, bring me the
cake.
Here I have the silver rose. Or shall we call for your Marianne? Let me ring.
No, let her be. She has a duty.
Thank you. goodness and your charm have led me on.
Pretentious, pompous fellow,
Thank you. Thank you.
come again, thyself be leading your bride from the wind by the hand.
I am a Bible and a Christian.
present now to your lordship, your bride-to-be.
It is my compliments to you. Are so delicate. That is just what I like. Among middle classes, it is seldom for me found.
Permit me to present my loyal servant, Marianne, Leitmetzerin.
Some other time. Come with me while I speak my Rosenkavalier. Someone whom I know. He has a sister. She's a sweet little bastard. That is no secret round the imperial court. A highness told me so herself. And she's a Faninal now that he's noble. He's one of us in a way. Do not be ashamed, my dear Afrano. At your father of soul, he's wild oats. He's not alone in that. He stands with the elite. I won't deny I've sown some corn.
You please refresh yourself. It's a very old brandy.
What a funny night. You know what right and fit to serve such a fine old brandy. Toast a fine young daughter. Not so badly. With two of any nobles like this one, we must show them that they are not our equals. You understand me? Persons like us have a duty to condescend.
I'm all gracious for your lordship.
Let me fetch the hussy here. See if she's learned how to talk in company. I shall discover if she's well informed. Hey, dear. Now let us hear you talk. Here at your cousin Charlie. And to begin with, what do you fancy would please you most as a bride?
You mean?
What's my meaning? Let me whisper in your ear, and I will tell you frankly all my meaning. Would my lady prefer it if I were to play the dancing master bowing and the walking with me, pardon, and devotion, and violin, and my mistake?
Undoubtedly, yes! But surely not!
None of that for me, miss.
How can it be?
I am an old
man. There shall no help set his heart upon a little Sophie. For thus was my demon and mine. And there stands not a crown of flames and live alone. And how does all know this?
My
diamond son of majesty's Lord, my Lord.
Why, you know in Paris, the very finest manners. There is naught that may be done by newly married folk. It is not usual to invite your friends.
What's wrong?
A beating head now.
What does my hands were of glass? Ever the petty foggy birdies in the town. Your mistress Henry should sweat his heart and
knee.
But that pleasure I give my witch. Out my plan on my side.
It's all right. Now be good. chicken.
Quite skinny, though. No matter. And so white, white as driven snow.
There's nothing I like more. I have the love of all the leisure now.
And what a fine little Christmas fire.
And see how hot the chips are burning. Up enough to burn my hand.
Oh, sister in law, attending here, acquainted with the lot. What an ill bred affray here in my house of all things. Has no one pitched a sudden yet? My tear horses, ride them all in it. How is it none of you masters of wit? Hold yourself between them. Why stop? Of liberal imbeciles, only for disgrace, to fall on me, and on my brand new palace. I had expected of your lordship your incomparable wit, to make a better show of pain than bleeding. Come now, tell me.
As you command me, Father, I shall unfold my story. My lord, then, has not acted as a man of
the world. How, of whom do you speak? Of my future son-in-law? If that is so, I beg you, think ere you speak.
It is not so.
For all your life.
some people dressed in tinsel.
Valerie, so much the soul of...
Strauss is here in my pocket. No, better not. If you can read, let's hear it. There. Without me.
What can my poor house still offer, your lordship?
A few more candles.
Better apartment.
A few more candles.
And all shall
be off. Or you will do the girl my ears.
For music in all the night.
Shall they be told to come and play in here? And while you dine, they'll play some music.
Leave your damn fiddles where they are. What is that little window there?
Tis only sham, my lord. Your lordship's up the way.
Stop! Black people's want.
We wait on your lordship.
I don't need help. Off now, my servant, shall all our serving be, and I can pour the wine out. Do you hear me? If you can get the bill, read just a little. Something may come your way. I'm sure it cost a fortune here. Sweetheart, what next? Come on, be so bashful.
No,
I swear by almighty consent. Soon bring us our supper. Something wrong with your appetite? Thank you. waiting and in dreams. Your face reminds me of a God-forsaken boy. Something there.
No, not a thing.
Not a thing. No, nothing there neither. That is your face, and nothing there. I think my head is going to
Oh,
makes him sad. It must be your closet. That's a hole in the heart. I must say, I am feeling Faninal, Sophie Anna Barbara, daughter to that most distinguished nobleman, Herr von Faninal, who lives in this palace quite near at hand.
The same, sir. What do you wish of me? How strange you go. I scarce expected you desire my presence at this untimely hour. Here in the common pot, how
why have you shut your nose in here in the day?
A damn stupid question indeed, the son-in-law. when your excited servants all but broke my door down to tell me I must come at once and save you from a horrid situation in which, through no fault of yours, you have found yourself.
Who is this man? What is he doing here?
It's not important, only an acquaintance.
It's just an accident he's staying here.
You may even tell me why you're here. I am the Baron of Faninal.
Yes, yes. All right, then, so you recognize this gentleman as your son-in-law.
Of course, why should I fail to recognize him merely because he's lost his wig?
And you have recognized a gentlemanly one because he learned it in their tiny father.
So, I'm not for all I know that may be so. This evening I have not been feeling very well. I can no longer trust my eyes. I must tell you there's something in this place that gives one apoplectic
turn. You, on the other hand, admit you are the father of this girl who has been described as your daughter.
As my daughter? That baggage, she says she is a child of mine. Tell my daughter to come here. The chair is at the doorway. She shall come at once. You may steal me. I will go to law. Who's that for me?
Nothing. A sweetness. I don't know this woman. She lies. She says that she's my lawful wife. Damn it to hell. I am like Daniel in the night.
Now look around. See there your noble suitor stands. And there his gracious lord's family. The wife and all her children. She's his too, but a morganatic wife. So that is you, as he himself has said. Not of the shame or hell. What do you do?
Thank you.
Girl, I have no time. Will you not wait until I come and call for you? Can you suppose that I present you in a brothel here?
Valerie, candles, the Marschallin, Octavian.
May I tell Faninal?